Guys, welcome to the show, and today's episode is going to be a little bit different because we are going to be discussing dual wield, aka akimbo pistol shooting. We're going to be paying homage to some of the most popular movies that we know from our childhoods of dual wield pistol shooting and discussing the relevance of how likely is it that you can successfully shoot two pistols at the same time. Before we get into a couple quick plugs, we do thank Craft Holsters for sponsoring the video today. We will be talking a little bit more about them, but they do make some pretty cool leather holsters, as you shall see momentarily. Ammo for the video provided by US Brass House. Appreciate their support. Codes 1911 and Syndicate saves you some cash on your ammo. Beyond that, if you guys need real estate help, I hope you know the deal by now. Hit us up. That's kind of our actual day gig. Patreon's link below. All that good stuff. Let's get on with it, everyone. Probably the most popular, if we really think, what are the most iconic movies where we have either a hero or a villain shooting two pistols? For me, you cannot have that discussion without starting with Face Off. That is correct. The 1997 John Woo classic that features Nick Cage as Caster Troy, who has two gold Springfield 1911s that he carries in a small at the back leather dual holster. Now, not only do I happen to have a set of matching Cabot 1911s, but Craft Holsters was nice enough to indulge my request to make a dual small of the back leather holster. One of the things that you, of course, will get from Face Off is that Caster Troy is incredibly efficient at drawing two pistols from the small of his back while diving out of an airplane and getting very accurate rounds on target. And it brews the question, just how quickly can you draw from a holster like this? So to get a baseline of how quickly I personally can draw from a standard holster and get a round on target, thank you,
sir. Keep talking, sir. Keep
our production assistant for the day. Christopher here is gonna give me a beep and we will just time it.
All right, shooter ready?
Yeah.
Stand by. .212.
All right, now let's compare that to a dual small of the back leather holster. I'm gonna blow a shoulder out. Now we're gonna run the shot timer on the dual pistol draw.
Shooter ready? Stand by. .325.
Okay, so that is a .212 single. A .325 with the double. Not bad, actually. Actually, better than I expected, if I'm being honest. Now to preemptively answer the question, Craft Holsters does have a custom shop where they'll do pretty much anything that you ask for. Don't ask for the double holster. That was a tremendous amount of work, but I do appreciate the favor that I was able to call in there. But they do also have a full lineup of regular leather holsters. We'll be doing a video on that, really on the concept of, do leather holsters still have a place in the year 2022? Maybe yes, maybe no, but we will talk about it. But we do, again, appreciate them jumping in and help sponsor this video. Okay, the next movie we are gonna talk about is my pick, I think a controversial one, for one of my favorite slash, I think one of the best and most innovative action movies of all time, which would be Hardcore Henry. Some of you may agree with me, some of you may disagree with me, but the plot of Hardcore Henry frankly doesn't matter because it's a movie about killing as many bad dudes as humanly possible and as fast as possible, which is why you of course want two pistols. So for this dual wield pistol test, we are going to look at how accurate can you be while shooting two pistols at the same time. So here's what we're going to do. We are going to run one pistol, two total mags, 16 total rounds on a shot timer. And we are going to track both time and the hit ratio running one pistol. And then we're going to do the same thing with two pistols.
Shooter ready?
Uh-huh.
Stand by.
all 8 hits on both mags, so 16 total. We're at 15-24.
15-24. And batting 10 out of 10 on the hit ratio there.
Yeah. Okay. 8 out of 8, but.
Yeah, well, 16 out of 16, technically. Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna reset. So we're gonna do the same thing, but we're gonna do it moving and shooting now. And then we're gonna switch to the dual versions of this.
Okay. Shooter ready?
Mm-hmm.
Stand by. Jump. So 12.94 with one miss.
So faster time.
Faster time.
Move, go figure. I move faster than I shoot stationary. Okay.
Cool.
Okay, so one miss out of 32 total rounds.
Yeah.
Not bad. I can live with that.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Now let's test it out with two pistols.
Cool. Ready? Stand by.
All right.
So there was a 2 in there, but it was not a 32, it was just 2.
Well, that was only 16 rounds. I got to do another round. So we got 2 hits?
2.
Okay, so 2 out of 16. Pretty good.
Sure.
It's pretty good. What was the time? I bet the time was good.
522.
522. That's a lot better than my 16 seconds before.
You want to see what your splits were?
Really?
First
good.
Shot off in 131, then, oh, wow, okay. 0.12, 0.43, 0.24, 0.31, 0.26, 26, 26, 26, 23.
Yeah. Sad thing is Lucas shoots like that with one gun. So I'm trying to catch up by shooting 2. But
I don't know if he's someone you want to emulate, but.
He's a ninja though.
All right.
That was good.
Time was 6:72.
Smoking. Hits?
0.
Are you sure that it was 0? Because I felt really good about that round.
So you have 2 rounds that landed out of 30.
Okay, so we might draw a conclusion that akimbo pistol shooting is perhaps not as effective as just one pistol.
But in the movies, they're like slaying it.
They're really good, and Henry was really good in Hardcore Henry.
Yeah,
so.
Huh.
All right, we'll keep practicing. Now, one of the things you will notice from the last 2 drills that we've run is that no reloads were performed. That's because reloading 2 pistols at once does present a little bit of an interesting dilemma. Which brings us to the 1996 classic, Last Man Standing, starring Bruce Willis. Absolute 90s classic. One of the valuable lessons we learn from Last Man Standing is that when you've got 2 pistols, you have a virtually unlimited supply of bullets. One of the other valuable lessons, of course, is that akimbo pistol shooting will blow a man clean off of his feet. But given in the case of the movie that he's shooting a 1911 chambered in 45, one round of 45, as we know, will blow a man clear through the saloon into the streets. But it does bring up the interesting question, how quickly can you reload 2 pistols? So what we're going to do, we are going to run a standard 1R1 with just a single pistol. We're gonna track the time, and then we'll do it with 2 pistols.
Cool. Shooter ready?
I am ready.
Stand by. We're at 4:22.
Okay, 4:22, certainly not the fastest, but I can live with it. Akimbo reload. The good news about this, twice the firepower. So even if it takes slightly longer than 4:22, twice firepower and twice the accuracy
and twice the misses. Okay. Shooter ready?
Here we go.
Stand by.
Yep.
going on. Money.
All right. Final time is 25.05 with two hits and two misses.
50%.
Your first shot off was in 1.32. Second shot off was 4.4. Your third shot was 22.73 seconds later. And your fourth shot was 5.6.
I'll take it. Absolutely thrilled with the time and the hit ratio. Fantastic. 50% frankly a lot better than I was expecting.
Hey, so. Yeah, good hits.
So. I'll take it. And speedy.
Cool.
Okay, on to the next. One of the things we, of course, have not addressed is the tactical advantages of using two pistols. Because when you have two pistols, you can either use them to send a lot of firepower onto one target, therefore killing them more, or you have the ability to address multiple targets at the same time. To illustrate this, we must bring up my version of the Punisher, which is Thomas Jane, okay? Thomas Jane is my Punisher. And in the Thomas Jane rendition, Frank Castle uses two 1911s, of course, chambered in 45, to address two hitmen on opposite sides of a lobby. Let's find out just how effective that technique can be. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start with one pistol, lame, and we're gonna address one target on this side of the lobby.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna transition slowly to this side of the lobby and address this thug, okay? And then we'll do it with two pistols simultaneously, which of course will be a superior technique.
Well, don't go slowly, go at a speed you're comfortable with.
I am, but it's one gun. You can only move so fast.
Okay. Here we go, shooter ready?
I am ready.
Stand by. Total is 354. First shot in 197, second shot in 157.
Okay, 354 total time.
Yes, sir.
All right, let's do it with two pistols.
Okay.
And with two pistols.
Shooter ready. Stand by.
Awesome.
So, first shot off in 0.77, fast and it only calculated one shot.
Fast as fuck. That's what happens when you're that fast. Hit ratio?
I think, let's see, zero.
But they scared, and they're running. They are running away now.
Because like, they probably went.
Son of a bitch has got two 45s pointed at us. We are out of this lobby.
Two world wars, brother.
So everyone, what can we learn about dual-wield pistol shooting? I think there's one movie that sums it up the best, which would be The Matrix. In one of the best scenes, Neo is on the rooftop and he's shooting two pistols, I believe Berettas, at Agent Smith. And the movie would make you think that Agent Smith has some sort of voodoo where he's dodging all the bullets. But the reality is that Neo didn't hit Agent Smith because you can't hit shit with two pistols. And this is sad because, as it turns out, Hollywood has lied to us. And on that bombshell, good night. You jump in this, please.
Now we want.
Yeah, I mean, this is just a quick summary, but I had a great way to end it.
Okay.
That I thought was a good observation.
Clever.
Actually, no. I'm sorry. Get out of here.